I think we're here, buddy.
Yes, sir.
Well, we gotta go down right there. You know what? I wanna leave my stuff over here again, I think. Doesn't look like anybody's touched it much. Get to go, man. Get to go. What's that?
My life barely made it look.
No, that's fine. That's fine. Don't need that down there for sure. Yeah. All right. Hi, welcome to the East Fork again, folks. Back in the spot we were at last week and a couple weeks before that. This is East Fork, early morning. We just got up on site. You see, stars are still out. It is going to be a beautiful day. There's our two dead trees. And there's old Rene checking it out. And there's that big old badass oak tree. Big ass oak tree, folks. Just a gorgeous, gorgeous tree. Living life to its fullest potential here at the East Fork. And there goes Rene. Gold Adventures. Have to get that shiny.
Good night, guys.
All right. All right, folks, good morning. It's about 6:30. Rene and I are back up here at the East Fork. Hiked in about an hour, and we're at Shoemaker Canyon again, where we were last week. And again, so it's 6:30. I got my box set up over there. Rene's got his box set up. He's already running dirt. So it's just now daybreak. We got a really, really good early morning start. It's gonna be about 80 degrees today and clear blue skies. Haven't seen anybody hiking on the trail yet, but I guess before we do, we're gonna get some dirt in that box and see if we can get some gold. So stay tuned. there, folks. You know, we've only been out here digging, I mean, literally digging, for 10, 15 minutes. And Rene calls me over to his box. And he said, hey, David, I think I got a picture. So we shine the light on it. I'm going to turn this around so you can see. All right, so check this out. Look at that big honking piece right there. And Jeff Williams would say, that's a monker. So, proud papa right there. He's going to pull his box and get that piece out of there. I'm going to kick him out of his hole so I can start digging there and get me some too.
That's a nice one.
True picker. He picked that shit up out the box. Hell yeah. Right. Put it on the matting right there. Look at that piece of gold right there. Hell yeah. Way to start the day, man. I bet you don't throw that one out.
No, look, it's low here.
Where'd it go? You need something to pick here. So here's a knife. There's a knife. He says he's got more gold down there too.
Yeah.
I don't believe him. That's Rene. Back from chasing down his Garrett Super Sluice gold pan. That thing went for a swim. Probably what, 50 yards? About 50 yards down river. So, good thing he got it back though. he's paying too much attention to all the gold he's getting to watch his equipment. Okay, so there was some other gold in here, but it washed out some decent pieces. Let's see, but right next to that rock, a little flake of gold, little flake of gold, little flake of gold, a few little flakes of gold. And there's some more higher up in the box that's in the black sand right now. But it looks like this area is still going to be productive, so I ain't going anywhere, man. I'll just keep running. There's another little piece down there. I'm just going to keep running. See what the end of the day brings. You see my tailings are piling up. Water's still good.
Take me to the Green Mountains, 'cause that's where the gold is at. If you wanna bend the rules, tell them this is not a sluice. It's just a fluid bed, and it's simply shovel fed. If you wanna get more gold, then I'll tell you where they're sold. Green Mountain Gold Trap. Made with pride in Vermont, USA. Order online at greenmountaingoldtrap.com or call 802-236-3886. Green Mountain Gold Trap.
Alright, so I don't know if it's better to show it in the shade. That's just what's showing on the top. This is my first clean out. I panned down the bulk of the black sand concentrates. Okay. And this isn't easy to, almost lost my snapper bottle. It's better in the shade. That is a lot of little gold. And that's just what's peeking through the top. That doesn't do it justice, but that pan is littered with gold. I ain't getting better than the last time, and I'm only 10 o'clock in the morning. All right, so tip it forward a little bit. Tip it forward. There we go. So this is Rene's take. There's some little stuff under that black sand, but he's got some decent big pieces. There's his cornflake. He's gonna put that in a cereal bowl, a couple of them. And he's got a 22. He pulled out a bunch of lead. There's a buckshot, a couple of 22 rounds. So he's in a good spot for heavies to drop out. So he just got to keep working that area. All right, I got me a cornflake too. A lot of micro stuff, a lot of little stuff, but there's a bunch of it. I think I did better this time than last time. Take two. I was sitting there talking for like 5 minutes and I realized I wasn't even recording. So anyway, Rene and I are calling it a day, packing it out from Shoemaker Canyon. Gotta say each of us did pretty good today. We did good last time too, but I think we did better this time. And we came in really early. I think we're on the trail just after 5 o'clock and we're leaving just before noon. But I think we got our fair share from that area. This will probably be my last video, at least prospecting video this year. And you know, the reason being is I promised my wife that over the holidays we'd make time to spend some quality time with the family. She's been very accommodating. And I appreciated her for that, letting me drag her out here and over and over and over. And this, you know, getting dirty and doing all of this isn't her thing. She enjoys the outdoors, but not as much as me, I think. I'd live out here if I could. But anyway, I've got... Oh. Okay, I ate shit. But I did it with style. I didn't end up on my butt or anything. Basically did a skateboard hand plant. So my each of our kids have kids now, and so we got three grandsons, and I think it's really important that we make time to spend some quality time. The youngest, this will be his first Christmas holiday, so it's really important to all of us to celebrate that as a family. Up or down? Down. So anyway, I've got some fabricating to do over the winter months. I gotta do some upgrades to my sluice. I gotta refabricate a sluice stand, and I got some other projects going on. So we'll take care of that over the cooler winter months, and we'll still post some content. Keep in touch.